Welcome, everyone, and thank you so much for listening to us. I know that these interviews are providing you with a lot of value. And today we have a special guest. We have Aniket Mishra. I hope I am pronouncing well the name. He is a YouTube growth strategist. He has been working for over 2 years with different personal brands and businesses and generated views as well as sales for his clients. He has also developed his own video sales funnel method that he teaches to his clients who wish to make more sales on YouTube. If you are one of them, stay with us until the end. Aniket, welcome.
Thank you so much, Diana, for having me here. It's been a pleasure being here, and I'm looking forward for the interview, and let's see what we can bring up to the people listening to us.
Amazing. Thank you so much. Aniket, tell us more about your story. What were some of the obstacles that you faced, and why did you decide to take this path?
So I was an ex-pro athlete. I was a 110 meter hurdler back when I started as a toddler, and I continued it for almost like 6-7 years. I graduated, and then I thought, okay, this is something which I need to pursue for. And then probably in India, due to some certain circumstances, we could not continue it. Then I got to know about digital marketing world through Gary Vee. I think a lot of us know who is he. And I got into the industry 3 years back. So I started as a social media manager, trying to help creators, but more of like in virtual assistant part, because I was not skilled enough. But eventually I got skilled and I was helping them, and it was great, it was going good. But I was not satisfied with whatever I was doing. It was like a monotonous job that I was going on in a day-to-day basis. And there was not something which was excited of me of, you know, this is something which I want to learn more about or get into deeper into aspect. But then all of a sudden I started jumping on, taking up other social media platforms like YouTube, LinkedIn, and all of those things, Twitter. And YouTube was something which, you know, brought that spark in me. And I was more keen to learn about the algorithm. I was more keen to learn about how YouTube metric works and everything around YouTube. And that was it 2 years back when it sparked up. And one of my clients, which she was getting an average view. She came up to me when she was almost having like 100 subscribers. In 6 months of time, we hit 1,000 mark. And plus the video views were very average. It was like 500 to 400 or maybe 1,000 views in a few videos. But again, she was able to scale her business. She was able to generate a lot of leads. And her $27 course almost sold to a number where she made almost $1,000 from YouTube in a month. And that time the channel wasn't monetized and she was investing a lot of money in editors, designer, and she hired me as an expert helping her out in YouTube thing also. But when she got the opportunity of earning about $1,000 a month, that sparked me up. It was not just a win for her, but it was a win for me too, because I knew to know like, okay, this is something which can be helpful to all of business owners out there, and the people aren't aware of it. So that's when I jumped out into YouTube full focused. Instead of being a very generic social media manager, I became a YouTube growth strategist back in like two years back. And yeah, that was the pretty much the journey.
Amazing, amazing. Thank you so much for sharing with us. I would like to ask you, because our mission at My Design Tomorrow is to share 1 million missions of coaches, trainers, and consultants. So I would like to ask you, what is your mission? What is really deep down? What is your passion? What is happening inside yourself that really drives you and motivates you?
For me, it has always been teaching, like from my childhood age. I was like all the Western culture came out in the picture in the last couple of years, where, you know, a lot of coaches come up in front and they started preaching about a lot of different stuff. But for me, teaching has always been a thing from the beginning. Like at my early childhood days, I was to teach to younger kids of like the people who were younger to me, and I was to preach. And I was that guy, people were, you know, frustrated because they were like, oh, Aniket, you know, he starts speaking, he starts preaching and all of those things in the group itself. So I've always been that person. And that has always helped me to be an educator before I became a marketer. So that has always been a thing. And even when I speak in the conferences where I go, or maybe I do a guest lecture in some colleges or wherever I go, I mention them that, you know, instead of calling me as a strategist or a marketer, I prefer by calling myself an educator, because I like teaching people, I like educating people in terms of why it is important and why still people aren't there. And just think about there are only 9% of business owners that are using YouTube in US market. So there's ample amount of opportunities people are missing out on. And that's the one of the missions that I have right now, is to teach people, is to make people go from point A to point B instead of just talking about basic stuff. I want them to give actionable steps. And there's no numbers to that I don't want. Okay, I want to help these amount of people in my lifetime or something. It's just about helping a person, just one person, and improving their life with just 1%. That's all is the aim. It's not about a huge numbers, but it's about helping just one person with 1% improvement in their life. And I think that can be done in the process, and it would impact a lot of people as a huge in terms of time as we move forward. It would be having a compounding effect. So that's what I think.
That's amazing. I really love this, because this is also something that I truly believe in. Because if you impact the life of one person, that person is going to impact another 10. And as you mentioned, there is the ripple effect that comes later on. And this is really actually what is the purpose of my design tomorrow, is to impact one person at a time, because they will impact later on millions of lives. And exactly. This is why we are here as coaches, trainers, and consultants, to impact the lives of other people, and also to show that there is another way to make this world a better place. Thanks exactly. So much for all the lessons that you are sharing with us. What I would like to ask you next is, you mentioned that there are business owners who are missing on opportunities and they should be visible on YouTube. Why do you think this is happening?
Because first of all, they aren't aware that what YouTube can give up to them. Secondly, it's a hectic process, recording videos. It's a very hectic process. People fear about recording. People have camera fear. People don't know how to do editings, do the graphics. And they aren't aware that it's a normal process. You just need to upload and things goes on with that. But again, it looks very hectic from above when you are trying to start it off. And that's one of the reasons why people are still taking the back foot while they are trying to get into the YouTube space or trying to get into the video marketing world. And I think that's one of the mistakes that they are doing, because if they really want to grow their business and if they really want sales on organic or leads on organic, YouTube is a space where they need to jump it off. And people talk about, oh, Aniket, you know, when I talk to people, they are like, Aniket, I think my market is cluttered. There are a lot of people out there. And I'm like, just imagine 2.3 billion people, there are monthly users on YouTube every month, not the year, every month. You still think that your market is not on YouTube. That's the question that I ask them, and they are like, oh, there's that. And you know, I'm very pretty much sure that they don't have an answer for that, because 2.3 billion people active users on YouTube every month is a huge, huge number of people. And there is your audience. There is your target market. You just need to define what you're going to sell. People try to sell to everyone. They think like, I will upload the videos and I need to get a million views. No, you need to understand, you are a business owner. Everything you upload on YouTube is not for everyone. If you have a product for gardening stuff, if you have a product for dog lovers, or if you have a product for Instagram marketers, it cannot be for the general public. It cannot be for people who came here for entertaining purpose. So they need to understand what it is important, what they are trying to target to, who they are trying to target to, and what's the core offer they have. And once they know all of them, they can hire a VA, they can hire a marketer and get them jump on the YouTube space. People actually, they are unaware about the opportunities that can come from YouTube. And they are unaware about the revenue generation people are making from YouTube. Instagram, Facebook, all can fade away. Like you upload a video on Instagram today, maybe 2 days people would scroll down or put stories or do, you know, shout outs and all those stuff, but then the videos die. But YouTube is an evergreen platform. It's a search engine. It's the second largest search engine. So it's an evergreen thing. The client that I was talking about in the earliest thing, she still gets sales on a video that was uploaded 2 years back when I jumped on her channel in 2018. She still gets views on that. She still gets subscribers on that. She still gets leads and sales on that particular video, which because they mentioned about the description, end screen, whatever website they have mentioned as a CTA. So she's still getting that. And that's the opportunity that has made me get into this space. And that's why I am on a journey to help other people understand and educate them in terms of why it is important and why they should jump on to YouTube to, you know, expand their business in whatever terms they can.
That's amazing. That's amazing. I really love this because this is also kind of eye-opening for me as well. I recently started a talk show, Secrets of Designing Tomorrow, on YouTube. We uploaded our first edition and now we are working on the following ones. And this is what I noticed, exactly what you mentioned. I got hundreds and hundreds of people clicking on my link and clicking and going through my website and checking out what I am doing. And indeed, you are fully right that actually there is a lot of opportunity out there that we are missing. And this brings me to a question, Aniket, that sometimes people only click on those videos which have many views or many followers. Why is this? What is happening in our subconscious, if you are aware of it? And why do we only go to the big names or the big things? Why do we think that those videos can be better than others?
So first of all, it's all about why YouTube for Business. Like, the question that arises in my mind after listening to your question is why people should apply for business as a YouTube, like expanding their business on YouTube. It's one of the things that people need to understand is YouTube is nothing. Marketing is nothing but psychology, understanding the human behavior. And in the same manner, it works on YouTube as well. First of all, people, the reason why people jump onto big shorts or the big industry or the big sharks in the industry is because it has already a trust factor in them. They have a lot of views, they have a lot of subscribers, and that builds up a trust. Let me come back to the same question, why you should, you know, start a business on YouTube is because there are a lot of factors that goes into the picture. You get a lot of reach. You are trying to have that discovery factor. Second thing is engagement, because people love to watch YouTube videos instead of watching blogs. And that helps them to generate a lot of trust inside that people's videos when they watch their people's videos, when they have a problem-solving approach to the people. And in terms while they build this kind of engagement and they have a lot of views in their channel, that brings up the trust factor why people are, you know, inclined towards getting into something which is more trustworthy. And the reason why people click on those people is because of the trust factor that I mentioned. What can people do in order to get into that space is to try to solve a smaller problem or try to solve a problem which is a very niche term. Let me come to an example that would be a much more better way to explain you in that terms. Let's suppose if you are a fitness freak and if you want to try to grow a fitness channel, you cannot make content on weight loss tips for anyone or weight loss tips for people. It has to be very specific. Now, being a woman, you can target to people of women category, just female. So you can make videos on weight loss tips for women or weight loss tips for women in that category or girls in for that matter. But again, there is a huge amount of women inside the world and there is a lot of population. You cannot stand out with the people who are already killing it on YouTube. What you need to do is to target a very specific kind of audience while you're trying to grow. What you need to do is, instead of targeting just weight loss tips for women, let me give you a context to it. In India, generally the women, they don't go to the gym. They try to prefer being at home, do yoga or whatever they try to do, but they don't go to the gym. Even my mother doesn't prefer going to the gym. It's her opinion, but it's completely what in India we have at least seen, that women, they don't prefer go to the gym. So imagine women who have a lot of weight loss problems, who want to do the weight loss things, but she cannot go to the gym for XYZ reason. Now, being a creator, what you can do is the content needs, strategy needs to be like weight loss tips for women over 40. Generally, after pregnancy, generally after women give birth to the child, their weight starts to grow and they are not cared about their weight and they are more inclined towards their babies and all those steps. That is the opportunity that you can grab and make videos or content regarding like weight loss tips for women over 40. So now you're targeting a very specific kind of audience. You're not targeting 1,000 people, but you're targeting just 400 people who are age group of above 40. So I'm not talking about there are only 1,000 people in the industry. Women, it's a lot. It's in billions. And even women over 40 are in lakhs and lakhs of views. You can enough get millions of views for that. Think about it. I just mentioned one layer to that, above 40. Think about weight loss tips for women who stay at home and are above 40. Now you have added another layer to that. Now you're talking about women who cannot go to the gym, how to have a home routine to it, how to have a home routine diet or home routine exercises or what can be, what dumbbells or what barbells or what weights you can get in your home and have a home gym. And you see where I go. You can have a whole content strategies on just home. Weight loss tips for women who stay at home. Now your target market is not just women who want weight loss tips, but women who stay at home and are above age of 40 and needs those kinds of tips. And once you start to target those kind of audience, once you start to target those ideal audience in your avatar, where you make your avatar, that's where you start to get the clicks. That's where you start to get the views. You won't get a lot of views. You won't get a lot of followers, but you would get the specific type of target audience that you are trying to search for. And then you can have a coaching program on weight loss tips for women who are staying at home. You can have a chart. You can have a cheat sheet on what are the diet they can follow at home. And hell lot of things can goes on into terms of info products or products or productivized services that you want to give to the people out there who are staying at home and who are above age of 40. So it all comes down to psychology, why people would click is if what problems you are solving for them, or you generate curiosity in minds of people when it comes to thumbnail and title. And then again, what problems you're solving to those people. So instead of targeting to a lot generic stuff, which already big creators are already doing, try to target specific kind of audience where you can rank, where you can get clicks, and where people are more interested in, those people who are trying to get into those industry are interested in. So that can be one of the things that can be helpful for you.
Amazing, amazing. You are really providing so much value to our listeners. Thank you so much, Aniket. I am proud and honored to have you here with us. And thank you for all the teaching that you are providing in this interview. I would like to ask you, linked to what you just mentioned, how do we reach the right target audience? And how many times do we have to post per week so that we can get some views on our videos?
So first of all, it's 50% of the game lies on the finding the ideal audience, and people need to understand, okay, what is that they're going to target to, whom they're going to target to. So the confluence of the content that you want to make is what your channel stands for. So the circle stands for what your channel stands for, and the second circle stands for what your audience cares for. And the confluence of both the circles is where your content lies. But the question is, I know what I'm going to make. Now I'm very much clear with what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to do a weight loss tips. Just imagine with the same example as we go. But we cannot target to everyone. So you have to have some smart guesses in the beginning. What happens is, in the beginning, it's really hard to identify who your audience is. So what you can do is, instead of just throwing the stick on the wall and presuming it or praying that that stick would stick to the wall, instead of doing that, instead of praying or, you know, having a very vague approach to this, you can have some smart guesses in terms of what can be the audience. Just imagine if you're trying to figure it out, women over 40 age or who are staying at home, you can go to the groups, you can go to the fitness groups, or you can have a pen and paper and write it down whom you're targeting to. So what are demographics they belong to? What sex they belong to? Are they female or male or other gender? Or what kind of age group they belong to? Are you going to target to age group of 40 to 55 where they require the fitness steps or all of those things that they cannot move out of the home or due to some of the other reasons, XYZ reasons? So you have to define your ideal audience in terms of age, sex, and then what they do and their online behavior and their offline behavior. Online behavior in terms of what kind of thumbnails they are clicking to. You can go to one of the shortcut methods to identify your audience can be having a competitor analysis on terms of, okay, I think Aniket, this is someone whom I look up to. This is someone I think I like to become in the near future. Go to the comment section of the videos that they post and see what people are asking for. See what questions they have in their mind. And then once you have those kinds of data in front of you, now you will know, okay, this is something that I need to target. This is a problem by these amounts of people that they're looking for. What happens is, when you are a big creator, it's not humanly possible for you to reply to all of those comments. But you, as a small creator, you have the time boundaries now. You can go through the comment and see what people are really caring for, what people are looking for. And you can define your audience from there. Again, you can go to Facebook groups, you can go to forums, you can go to Reddit and find out what people are doing. Find out what people you are trying to target to and hang out with them and try to see what problems they have. And then you can define, okay, this is something which I think I can target to. And once you try to make content according to that, after at least 20-25 videos is uploaded on the channel, you have the data in the YouTube analytics. Before that, it's just smart guesses. So in the beginning, instead of procrastinating of, oh, I don't know the audience, what should I do? Just go do a competitor analysis, see and take a smart guess on what can be. Make an ideal audience, write it down, whom you're going to target to, what age group, what sex, where they belong to, if they belong to metro cities or big towns or small cities, do they live in home, they do go outside, can they go to the gym, or if they cannot go to the gym, what can be the home remedies, what are the other things, if they have the buying persona, if they can, you know, do the purchasing thing online or not. So you have to take those kind of smart guesses and go through, okay, if this is something you can do, or put out polls on your social media and ask for people for feedback. And then you can start making a content on YouTube and ask for feedback in the comment section. Oh, what do you like to make me content on? Something like that. And feedback is a queen. Like, people talk about content as a king. I talk about feedback as a queen. The more feedback you get, the better you get. And the feedback, if the feedback loop is small, you grow faster. So finding an audience is really important. And that's how you try to figure it out. You know it. Okay, this is something which we're trying to target to. And then you amplify in that manner and try to make content on that.
Thank you so much, Aniket. Thank you once again for all this valuable information you are providing to us. I know that for those who are listening, this may sound like overwhelming, like, oh, do I have to do all of this research? How am I going to do it? Where do I start? Can you help people? Can you do it for them? Can you help them maybe identify their target audience? I don't know, ask questions to clarify, to really understand what they want, what they are looking for, and then do all this analysis for them. Do you do this?
Yeah, I provide with two for you management services and then consulting services for people as well. But yeah, that's something which I do. And, you know, I help people in, apart from that, from the coaching also. In teaching them how things work and how algorithm and everything they can set up their funnel and put up the things on their business side.
Thank you so much. How can people contact you if they want to really enjoy, if I can say, the services that you are providing?
I'm highly active on Facebook these days. I'm trying to get back in my content creation journey on Instagram. But Aniket Mishra Live is somewhere they can find me out. AniketMishraLive.com is the website that is under construction. I'm trying to build up that too. On Facebook, they can reach out to me on Aniket Mishra, Aniket Mishra Live on Instagram, Aniket Mishra Live on LinkedIn, or anywhere they want to find me. Aniket Mishra Live is the tag they can search out in the Google and find me up there.
Thank you so much. Amazing. I am really excited to have you here. And for those listening to us, go and ask for help, because you cannot do everything by your own. And I know, as a small business, and this is also my experience, we can become so overwhelmed with all the tasks that we have to do, whether it's about marketing, sales, and putting all the pages together. And this is really the purpose of My Design Tomorrow, to help you design your tomorrow, to help you identify those coaches, consultants, and trainers who can help you push forward your business. But it goes beyond that. They can help you push forward your life. They can help you design your life. This is our aim. So stay connected for the next videos and contact Aniket. You are going to see below the link to his details, and you can contact him anytime.